out of the question.
He heard what the other winners said happened the night they won.
It sure made it difficult to sleep.
Good afternoon, everybody. This is Charlie Jones and Todd Christensen. Welcome to Mile High Stadium, where today the Denver Broncos will host the Kansas City Chiefs. And in the AFC West, first a look at the temperature. It's a gorgeous afternoon. The temperature is 74 degrees. Just a bit of a breeze. The forecast is sunny. And now to those standings. I was in such a hurry. They're tied atop of the West. Denver and Kansas City, identical records of 3-1. Marty Schottenheimer, the head coach of Kansas City, former head coach of Cleveland. His overall record against John Elway is 1-8 at 0-5 at Mile High Stadium. What did Marty have to say about that? Well, here is his quote. I'm going to stay home. I really don't want to evaluate it until my coaching career is over. Then I want to step back and figure out exactly how much money John Elway has cost me.
Well, we know for a fact that he cost him two trips to the Super Bowl when he was there with the Cleveland Browns. And, of course, the last couple of years, he's certainly been a nemesis of his here in the AFC West. And today, he and his Chiefs are looking to break that decade-long jinx that they've had here at Mile High Stadium.
Denver won the toss. They'll be receiving Nick Lowry to kick off with Marshall and Montgomery, the return man. And Montgomery will down it in the end zone, and Denver will go to work at their own 20-yard line, led by the man himself, John Elway. But his completion average is just barely over 50%. Elway will be joined by Gaston Green and Reggie Rivers in the backfield. Russell Jackson, the wide receiver, Terrence Kay is the tight end. And that offensive line of Freeman, Davis, and Karch, Wydell, and Lanier. And Russell Freeman, the rookie at left tackle, has his work cut out for him today, as he will be across from Derek Thomas all afternoon. They start with the H-back, Shannon Sharp, and they put him in motion. And Elway hits Shannon Sharp. And he opens with a completion. He'll pick up about 9 yards on the play. Martin Bayless with the tackle. And defensively, the front seven, Smith, Salimua, that foot is okay. Moss, Martin, Randall, Simeon, and Derek Thomas. And in the secondary, Lewis, Ross, Bayless, and Mincy. They spotted at the 28-yard line, so it'll be second down and two.
One of the things that Denver wants to do is keep this defense off balance, and by throwing on first down, coming up second and two, that certainly helps the creativity of the offense for the Denver Broncos.
And the H-back, Shannon Sharp, in motion. And here is Gaston Green, a little hip move to the outside, and he is then brought down by Chris Martin.
Well, Gaston Green, you remember last year, had the 1,000-plus season, had a number of runs over 40 yards, and went to the Pro Bowl. And of course, it was his play that made Bobby Humphreys expendable so they could trade him to Miami. But thus far, he's had a difficult time getting on track. 45 carries for 120 yards. He has yet to really exemplify the style and skill that made him a Pro Bowl back last year.
Third down and one. Vance Johnson back from that injury. He had the shoulder surgery the last week in July, is into the set. Reggie Rivers is also there. And the give is to Rivers. He needs a yard. He needs to get to the 30, and he does.
He got past the 30-yard line, but Charlie, there's something right there that exemplifies the lack of confidence that the Broncos have in their running game. Here you have third and one. What do you win? You're in a spread formation, three wide receivers. You know, they go to the trap inside. Randall tackles it, but not before he gets across the line. But maybe that says something about the Broncos' confidence in their offensive line, that they have to spread them out on third and one.
And the ball resting just past the 30-yard line. And his first down, Denver, opening drive of the ball game. No score. The Denver Broncos and the Kansas City Chiefs. Couple of yards, maybe three. Bill Moss and Neil Smith make the tackle.
Big matchup, as you mentioned at the top of the show, Charlie, is going to be Russell Freeman, Derek Thomas coming out. Shannon Sharp in motion. Thomas comes back in and helps in a little bit to stuff that play.
A
lot of the key to the success of the Denver Broncos is going to be their ability to mute that man and his ability to sack the passer. As everybody knows, this is the man who LT himself said, if there's another LT out there, he said, it's that guy in Kansas City.
Second down and 7. Start the motion, Elway to throw. And it is almost intercepted. Perez K couldn't hold on to it. Randall had it. And Irvin juggled it and then dropped it. It is incomplete.
Clarence K has the reputation of the National Football League as being one of the best blocking tight ends there is, but certainly not pass catcher, as exemplified right there. Has his hands turned the wrong way, and he was lucky they didn't get that one intercepted by Randall. Watch Clarence K's hands. Watch where his hands are. They should be down instead of up so he can cradle the ball between the eights. Instead, Denver Broncos very fortunate they didn't give Kansas City a turnover.
What about Randall's hands? Where should they have been?
Well, he's a linebacker. He's not supposed to catch it. If he could catch it, him on the other side of the ball.
Third down and 7. Elway has pressure and he is sacked. Ball pops loose. Denver recovers it. And Neil Smith got it.
Marty Schottenheimer said that this is the man right now who's playing the best football for the Kansas City Chiefs. Just takes the outside move, a little shuffle, arm under, gets right past Lanier, gets to Elway, and with that wingspan brings him down. And a la Johnny Carson, take a look if you can see at the end, Neil Smith. He does kind of a batting thing there with the swing. Had the nose broken earlier in the season, 32 career sacks you can see right there. But he plays the whole game. Mike Schottenheimer made it a point to say that.
Mike Duran kicking, and it goes out of bounds. They'll mark it at around the 23-yard line. We have no score. We'll be back in a moment.
Are you guys having it your way? They're entranced. They're having it their way so much.
This place.
Look, they're all four of them are staring. No, you can't have any. If you want some breakfast, you have to go to Burger King. You can't have mine.
It's breakfast at Burger King.
No, get off. You see George Rich? It was like, give me that. Liquor sandwich for 99 cents?
Does that sound like a good deal to you, Abe?
Yeah, man, it sounds like a peachy deal to me.
Abe's a smart man.
The 99 cent per sandwich.
Are you guys having a joy away?
Right away.
Mm-hmm. They love this place.
I have to admit, I'm a little surprised.
About what?
I just never thought I'd see you in anything but a BMW or a Lexus.
Me neither.
Airbag? Leather? This is quality. Expensive?
About 10, 15,000 less than the BMW or Lexus. I think it feels just as good.
What? Oh, this Pontiac Bonneville. It's amazing.
If your face was square, shaving would be simple, but your face has curves. Presenting the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the only twin-blade razor that flexes to follow the curves of your face. Schick Tracer, we're changing the face of shaving.
She's trapped by terrorists. Her only hope is a cook.
Oh, God, we're gonna die.
Steven Seagal, Tommy Lee Jones.
This is not the work of a cook.
Roger that.
Under Siege, rated R. Starts Friday, October 9th at a theater near you.
Kansas City will be on offense for the first time in the ballgame with Dave Craig at quarterback. The running backs are Barry Word and Bill Jones. With Fred Jones and Willie Davis, the wide receivers. Jonathan Hayes is the tight end. And that offensive line of John Ault, Dave Zott, Tim Grunhard, David Lutz, and Rich Baldinger. Remember those names? We'll be talking about them throughout this game.
Certainly one of the more underrated offensive lines in the National Football League. Doing an outstanding job opening the holes for Barry Word.
First down, 23-yard line. And the pitch to Word. He makes the cut. He's across the 30, the 35. And the last man gets him. Tyrone Braxton saves the touchdown. 26 yards.
This is just a matter of poor tackling here. He cuts to the left, and it looks like they have it boxed in. Now watch when he makes the cutback. The pursuit of the linebackers just isn't there. Dennis Smith gets cut. Now watch if he cuts back here. If he cuts back against the grain, Braxton's the only guy left. If he could have waited just a little bit longer there with J.J. Burton, he might have gone the distance.
First down, 49-yard line. Jones is in motion. Word again. to the 46-yard line. He picks up five. It'll be second down and five. And defensively for Denver, it is Soche, Cragen, Walker with the linebackers, Kroll, Brooks, Mecklenburg, and Fletcher. And in the secondary, Braxton, Henderson, Smith, and Atwater.
Keith Traylor is in for the injured Michael Brooks. Michael Brooks had a deep thigh bruise earlier in the week, and so as a result, they had him, Traylor, coming in to play some inside backer for him.
Second down and five. The ball at the Denver 46-yard line. No score in the ball game. Just over 10 and a half minutes left to go. We're in the first period. Play action fake by Craig. He pumps. He wants to go deep. It's not there. He has to come back underneath the coverage to Word. It is incomplete. Excellent coverage on the left corner by Braxton. He did not bite on the fade.
That's absolutely right. They had the hook and go there. Interesting call there at second and five. But Tyrone Braxton backpedaled and had him in coverage. Take a look at the pressure here. Greg Cragen, rather, nose tackle, is not usually known as a pass rusher. But look at the pursuit he goes after. Hands and knees, all fours. Persistent there. About 265, between 265, 270 pounds. And in today's nose guard, who is sometimes is 300 plus, he's one of those statistical anomalies.
Third down and five. Pressure and the sack at the 45-yard line. Jeff Mills.
Wade Phillips said that Jeff Mills would be playing a lot for the Denver Broncos today because of his pass skills in the defense, but instead here he actually is a rusher here, and he spikes Dave Craig. Wade Phillips has him in there because of his great coverage on Todd McNair, but here you're going to see him coming from the left completely unblocked. Excellent stunt here by the Denver Broncos. Craig never sees him. He never had a chance.
Barker to kick, has pressure. Arthur Marshall, the return man, fair catch. As he looks into the sun, he takes it at the 12-yard line. We have no score. 9 minutes and 50 seconds left to go. We're in the first period. Back in a moment.
Hey, I thought you were a Honda for Life guy, huh? What happened?
Well, this happened.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I love the way it drives. Handling, the control, it just feels really connected to the road. Even has anti-lock brakes standard.
Oh, come on, what? You can't get ABS in the Accord, huh?
Oh, yeah, for about $4,000 more.
So what is this?
The new Grand Am. It's a Pontiac.
We are driving, excitement, Pontiac.
I'd love to drive it.
I'll bet.
Now at Little Caesars, cheeser, cheeser. Two pizzas with extra cheese, up to three toppings, and free crazy bread for $8.98.
Teaser, teaser.
Time to think about life insurance? Let your Allstate agent work it out on paper. Everything from mortgage protection to a plan for a breezy retirement. Let your Allstate agent be your agent for life. You're in good hands with Allstate.
NFL on NBC is brought to you by Pontiac and your nearby Pontiac dealers. We are driving excitement. By Little Caesars Pizza, where you always get two great pizzas for one low price. By the Diamond Anniversary Band, this year tell her you'd marry her all over again. And by Cold Filtered Miller Genuine Draft, get out of the old, get into the cold.
Welcome back to Mile High Stadium on this absolutely gorgeous afternoon in Denver. Broncos' second opportunity in offense when we have no score, as Elway starts from his own 12-yard line. And he's going to pick up about 4 yards on the play. Maybe to the 16-yard line. Let's see where they spot it. Saliamua making the stop.
So So many times in the past, Charlie, these games have been decided by turnovers, and you could see deep in their own territory that at this point the Broncos don't want to take too many chances, want to be conservative here inside their own 20.
They spotted at the 15-yard line. It'll be second down and 7. Reggie Rivers in motion. Pressure gets the pass off. It is caught at the 25-yard line. Shannon Sharp with the reception, and Randall was all over it.
Well, Shannon Sharp is kind of a tweener, somewhere between a wide receiver and a tight end. You can see right there off of Urban Randall, he pushes off, dives to make the catch. Outstanding grab there, bouncing off the inside backer, number 84, Shannon Sharp, younger brother of the great Sterling Sharp of the Green Bay Packers, but he wants to make his own niche. He's tired of that. He wants to be known on his own terms. Of course, then again, his brother didn't catch 90 passes in one season.
That's true. And here's a sweep to the right side with Gaston Green. Good defensive play by Martin Bayless. Bayless, one of only three members of the Kansas City Chiefs who have a victory, who have tasted victory here at Mile High Stadium.
And here's this is why he has the nickname Bam Bam. Goes right through the block there of Victor Jones and upends, I mean literally upends, Gaston Green on his noggin. Martin Bam Bam Bayless. His wife Pebbles doesn't appreciate that, but nonetheless, that's the nickname he has. That's my version of humor, which obviously went on deaf ears. Okay, well, we'll leave that
well,
one.
Well, I was busy at the time, fortunately.
When we talked with Martin last night, he made the point that he said how what a thrill it is to be in a team that's 3-1 as opposed to his old Charger team, which of course is 0-4.
Elway, lots of time. The pass is complete. It is Reggie Rivers. And he just fights his way to the 30-yard line. He picks up a total of 9 yards on the play. So it's going to be 3rd down and 5.
Well, last week against the Cleveland Browns, Reggie Rivers solidified his position as the starting fullback for the Denver Broncos. And, of course, here he is standing up against Dale Carter, kind of a wide receiver situation. They're looking to him to do some of the things that Steve Sewell has done for them in the past, to have that kind of versatility. And of course, last week against the Browns, he had a 48-yard run. And, of course, his play enabled him this week to waive Robert Perriman, who before had been their starting fullback.
3rd down and 5. Marshall is in motion. Elway to throw from the shotgun. And he's going to scramble for it. He can be dangerous. And he makes it. He'll pick up the 1st down. Doug Terry makes the tackle. But Elway, who has that elusive speed, you really don't think he is that quick until he needs that extra yard.
This is frustrating for defenses right here. Great coverage in the secondary, outstanding man-for-man coverage, but because you're man-for-man, you have your back turned. And even with Charles Mincy in the middle of the field watching John Elway, who is still able to get up, utilize his speed and his escapability to get the 1st down.
He needed 5, he got 6. 1st down at the 36-yard line. Greg Lewis now in the backfield for the Broncos. And he's the ball carrier. And he's going to get a couple of yards. Let's mark it to, I'll call it the 38-yard line. And it'll be 2nd down and 8. They'll spot it closer, just outside the 38-yard line. It's 2nd down. Second opportunity in offense for Denver. No score. Kansas City's had the ball once. Elway with all the time in the world. He's throwing that away. He figured enough is enough.
That was really a one-man pattern trying to get it to Shannon Sharp, and I mean Martin Bayless was all over him. He just had him by the jersey, and I'm looking at Charlie Waters down the sidelines absolutely screaming at the back judge. Shannon Sharp right now is having a bit of an argument with the official as it is.
Now let's go back to the comment on Martin Bayless, one of three members of the Kansas City Chiefs who have won here at Mile High Stadium. He, of course, won when he was with San Diego. Dave Craig won when he was with the Seahawks, and Nick Lowry is the only Kansas City Chief who won here in a Chief uniform. 3rd down. Arthur Marshall pulls it in at the 48-yard line of Kansas City. Doug Terry with the tackle.
What Arthur Marshall does here is his ability to find a seam in the zone. This is very rare when you have the opportunity to have a young receiver who can see in the seams. Right here in the seam is where Marshall's going to come down. Instead of turning out and running into the defender, he's going to idle down, and Elway is going to be able to find him for the first down. Very rare that you have a young receiver that has that heads-up ability. Right there, he slows down before he's going to get hit by Darryl Malone. First down for the Broncos. Good play by the youngster.
The middle by Gaston Green to the 41-yard line. Gain of 7, and it will be second down and 3. Neil Smith with the tackle. Let's go back to just a moment to Arthur Marshall. When we talked to him yesterday, he is a free agent. And when we talked to him, we asked him what draft day was like. He said it was horrible. I said, how was the second day? He said it was even worse.
But you know, the flip side of that, Charlie, which a lot of the young players realize, is that if you don't go on the first day, the first 5 or 6 rounds, then after that, if you don't go, then you get to pick where you want to go. And in his case, it turned out to be a godsend because of the injuries to the receivers for the Denver Broncos.
And Reggie Rivers spins for the first down, 37-yard line of Kansas City.
You know, they talk about how players play big. Reggie Rivers is listed as 6'1", 215 pounds, and by the NFL standards, that's not a very large fullback. But by the way he runs much larger. Take a look at the number of tackles he breaks here. One at the line of scrimmage, there's another one. He breaks through Simeon's hand tackle, runs through Albert Lewis to get the first down. Reggie Rivers showing that he's a lot stronger than the normal 215-pound back.
First down, Denver. Ball just inside the Kansas City 37-yard line. Denver started this drive back at their own 12-yard line. 3 minutes and 13 seconds now the time remaining in the first quarter with no score.
False start prior to the snap on the offense, number 88. 5-yard penalty. It remains first down.
Ed Hockley is our referee today.
Clarence Kay. Watch the bottom of your screen right there, Clarence Kay. What people forget here, though, Charlie, is that as a receiver, technically he could do that if he gets back. But if it's an intentional move to draw the guy off sides, evidently that's what the official felt. Because I know as a tight end, I flinched a couple of times. I was able to get back, and it was all right.
Elway has completed 4 of 6 for 40 yards. First and 15. Misses shot, and it'll be second down and 15.
John Elway has done a good job thus far in this particular drive executing the offense. As has been mentioned earlier in the season last year, the 1991 season, John Elway, to get himself more involved in the game, decided that he wanted to call the plays, call his own plays. And near the end of the season, he got to where it was about half and half where he was calling and Dan Reeves was calling the plays. Now this year in 1992, right off the bat, he said, forget it. It's you, Dan. You make the calls. I'll just execute what's on the field.
And also, Dan is sending most of the plays in rather than signaling them in, sending them in with players. He said, you know, you can just make a better call. Tips, it is incomplete. Tracy Simeon makes the defensive play.
Now, you were talking about hands earlier, Charlie, with regards to his inside backer partner, Irvin Randall. That was certainly a very catchable ball. Tracy Simeon has really made a name for himself. This is an inside backer who, if you recall, his major claim to fame was that he was the guy that had the helmet cam during the World League football days. Watch him right here. He knows that he should have had that one back. But not only did he go from the World League here to the Kansas City Chiefs, but he's their leading tackler, and he's the main reason why their first-round pick of 2 years ago, Percy Snow, is sitting on the bench.
And when he talked about John Elway yesterday, he said you could put a 2 in front of his number, make it 27, and he's a running back. Elway rolling right. Throwing back across the field, and it is incomplete. Mark Jackson, the intended receiver. It'll be fourth down.
Give a lot of credit here to the secondary of the Kansas City Chiefs. They know that he has the ability to throw completely across his body and complete those kinds of passes. John Elway had a lot of time. This is what's called turmoil. They pinch down on the defense. Now, here comes Derek Thomas. He's relentless. He knows that he still has this speed. Watch at the last minute. He's right there. Even though he's completely blocked out of the play, he's still in Elway's face. 4-5 speed. 6'3", 242 pounds. Derek Thomas is always a threat.
Mike Duran will be kicking. Wants to just hang it up. Goes for the corner, and he gets it. And let's see where they mark it out. They're going to mark it out at the 6-yard line. 2:27 left to go. First period. No score. Back in a moment.
Get butterflies.
Funny, she doesn't look married. I bet she cries or bites her lip.
Hello, stranger.
I'm hardly a stranger.
Well, you are late.
I know. You shouldn't have waited 10 years for this. Happy anniversary.
The Diamond Anniversary Band. Tell her you'd marry her all over again.
You sure can't pick an appetizer.
Take one and action. Hey, what's the best thing about breakfast at McDonald's?
Coffee.
Pour out of the cup, it's steaming, it's dark and rich.
I pour it personally.
Coffee fresh?
Fresh brewed. Fantastic cup of coffee.
So what's the secret?
Arabica.
Oh, what's an Arabica?
Arabica beans.
Oh, the beans. And what else?
It's always fresh.
It just tastes good.
And they like to come in and talk with each other, and just like the small coffee shop long ago.
How much a coffee refill?
They're free.
What you want is what you get.
It's guaranteed.
What's up?
Yeah.
Yeah, I looked at the BMW and the Lexus.
And?
I drove this. The power, the handling, the control. It was incredible.
Really?
It's got leather, ABS, dual airbags. It's even supercharged. I could have spent a lot more on the BMW or the Lexus. But why? What is this? The new Pontiac SSEI.
We are driving.
Very nice.
Excitement, Pontiac.
Welcome back to Mile High Stadium. This is Charlie Jones along with Todd Christensen. And I think that we've seen in the first quarter, in reality, the theme of this football game.
That is playing it, as Hank Stram used to say, because he wore them all the time, close to the vest.
Yes, yes.
Not taking any chances early on. And, of course, a lot of these games we know in the past have been decided by 3-4 points. The last thing they want to do is do something stupid and have a turnover early in the game.
Kansas City, second opportunity on offense. No score in the ballgame. From their own 6-yard line, flags are down. Very worried, the ball carrier, Cragen with the tackle, and it looked as if the Broncos were in the neutral zone when the ball was snapped.
And it appeared, Charlie, that it was Kenny Walker. If indeed that's the call, it could have been that he was drawn off.
Offsides on the defense, number 96, 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
It is Kenny Walker, number 96. It's interesting that he should be drawn up.
Yeah, interesting because of the fact that, of course, you're well aware at this point, if you've been following Denver Bronco football or football in general, that this man is the only deaf player in the National Football League. So Kenny Walker is someone who has to look in at the ball to be snapped. He would be fooled by a hut-hut.
I was on a Caribbean cruise with the NFL players. He was there. But I said hello to him. He said, well, your stomach is flatter now than it was at the end of the cruise. And that took a lot of signing to do to explain that to me, what he was talking. No, he just made the big move.
Yeah, well.
All right, Barry Word carrying with Cragen and Soche on the tackle.
I'm just angry that you wanted a Caribbean cruise and I didn't. But never mind that you were fat.
I know. Well, that was only a momentary. Second down and two. The ball at the 14-yard line. We're seeing, as Todd was pointing out when we were on camera a moment ago, the conservative approach for both ball clubs. Willie Davis comes in motion, and you expect Kansas City to run the ball, and they do again with Barry Word. When we talked with Marty Schottenheimer, he said that Barry Word was a pick and slide type of runner. We'll see Christian Okoye. He's the big, powerful runner. And we'll also see today Harvey Williams, who is a slasher. He hits and spins. So the three key running backs for Kansas City, all with a different mode of attack.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And, of course, a lot has been documented with the facts that, of course, Christian Okoye in 1989 was the leading rusher in the National Football League. They drafted Harvey Williams in the first round last year. He showed them a lot of speed and versatility. But thus far, particularly in the last two games, the brunt of the load has been carried by Barry Word.
Barry Word, 6'2", 245 pounds, and here he comes again. He is pushed back. The flag is down.
I don't think they got the playoff, Charlie. Saw the back judge come screaming in there and throw his flag, trying to stop the play.
So it will be a delay of game, and it will be third down and six. Here's the call.
It's a delay of game on the offense before the ball was snapped. 5-yard penalty, it remains third down.
And Charlie, there's a big difference here between third one and third and six for a team like Kansas City. For Denver, who is not known as a slug them out kind of running game anyway, we noticed earlier on the third one, they went with a three wide receiver package. Of course, Kansas City feels like they can ground it out third one, third and two, third and three, but once they get past third and four and third and five, they're forced to throw the ball.
And Craig fires and is complete at the 20-yard line for the first down. He goes to Emil Harry, and he is brought down by Charles Dimery at the 20. He needed six, he got 10, first down. And with that play, we come to the end of the first quarter, and we have no score between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Denver Broncos.
Just because you got 2.3 kids. Just because you got a house, a lawn, and a mortgage. Just because you're now a responsible adult, you still know how to have a good time, don't you?
The new Grand Am Sports Sedan.
Castrol GTX is the only leading motor oil that meets the world's toughest requirements for viscosity breakdown in every grade. This is the only way to get that kind of performance from any other leading brand. Castrol GTX, engineered for today's smaller cars.
When it's this greasy, you need a more powerful cleaner degreaser. Castrol Super Clean solubilizes grease on contact, neutralizing its ability to stick. So if it won't come clean with Super Clean, it won't come clean. Filtered. Miller Genuine Draft. For those who've discovered its real draft taste, the world is a very cool place.
With the waving of Stephon Paige, the Kansas City Chiefs are looking for somebody to be that possession receiver. And Marty Schottenheimer told us that the closest they have to it is Emil Harry. Here he comes down in the slant route right here inside the 20 to get the first down. Craig puts it right on the numbers, but of course, none of the receivers play all the time. Stephon Paige, of course, was somebody who played every down. What's been happening here is they've been shuffling people in and out, and now because of some injuries, they have to do that even more. And I really think, Charlie, that that hurts the continuity of a quarterback, not being able to get used to one or two specific receivers.
May not affect Kansas City that much because they rely so much on their running attack. Versus their throwing attack.
But you know that down the line, if they're down by 7 or 10 points in the fourth quarter, they got to throw the ball.
And here is Word out to the 24-yard line. Gain of four will be second down and six. Steve Atwater making the tackle along with Braxton. A check of the 10-minute ticker. Minnesota coming from behind in the fourth quarter, scoring three touchdowns and three extra points for that win.
Dennis Green has them going there now. 4-1. They're leading the NFC Central. And Tampa Bay could have tied them if they would have defeated Indianapolis today. But in falling now, they go to second place at 3-2.
And a big win for the Colts. Giants and Raiders no score.
Jeff George is back.
Yes.
Yeah, that had a lot to do with it.
That'll make the difference. Washington with the early lead over Phoenix. And here is Barry Word on the corner. He is the only Kansas City Chief to have carried the ball thus far in the ball game. Tyrone Braxton with the tackle.
Well, that's not really surprising, Charlie. His fullback, Bill Jones, in 1991 had no carries in the entire year. What Barry Word contributes here, look at that. 6 foot one, 245 pounds. You don't think that a guy that size can get to the outside, but he can. And his ability to bounce to the outside and lower his pads at 240 plus pounds, that's tough on the secondary of the Broncos.
He comes out for a breather, and Christian Okoye replaces him, and there's no rest for the defense. Okoye at 6'1", 260 pounds. Back to throw, and he'll swing to the left side. Is complete to Fred Jones, and he goes out of bounds after a gain of 9 yards on the play.
Marty said something interesting about Fred Jones yesterday. I don't know if this is something that I think he obviously takes pride in it. He said that Fred Jones is the best blocking wide receiver I have ever been associated with. If you happen to see any of the Monday night game, you saw him put a couple of excellent licks on Ronnie Lott, enabling Dave Craig to get some touchdown runs. He said about 5'11", 180 plus. He said he's one of the wiriest 180 pounds he's ever seen. He has a nerve to say that he was a better blocker than I was.
He said that Fred Jones has that, like a slugger has a 6-inch impact. And talk about impact is Christian Okoye to the 50-yard line, and he picks up the first down.
We talked a little bit about Fred Jones blocking. Take a look. Top of your screen there, number 80, coming down on people. A lot of times what you get from wide receivers are these are the guys that just cut people. There, he didn't necessarily do the job, but maybe it had to do with the fact that Steve Atwater at 6'4", 217, isn't like your normal cornerback. He's a big man there in the secondary, 100-plus tackles guy. Does not get back soon enough, and as a result, puts it right on the money. The reason it's a touchdown, he laid on top of Braxton. He wasn't down. He wasn't on the ground. That's why it's six. That's what the referee is explaining to the people in the stands, and they're booing, but if we get a chance to see it again, take a look when he falls down. He's going to fall down right on top of Braxton. What a throw here by Craig. Right on the hands. Davis is going to catch the ball. Now watch where he falls. As he gets pulled over, he falls on top of his body. He's not on the ground yet. Now he's on the ground. And when he's on the ground, he's over the goal line. Heads up by the officials.
Nick Lowry with the extra point. And it is good. And for Willie Davis, his first career touchdown in the National Football League. And Kansas City takes the lead 7-0.
When you don't have to send your package overnight, you can save yourself a bundle.
What a difference a day makes.
Two-day priority mail service.
24 little hours.
From your post office. Send up to £2 in just 2 days for just $2.90. That's right. That's some difference.
What a difference a day makes. We deliver for you.
My last business trip was
of nowhere.
The most unpleasant.
The middle of nowhere.
Every day, 2 million travelers set out to do business.
Last year I traveled 65 days.
Who would know better what they need than Holiday Inn?
I always rehearse my presentation.
In front of the bedroom mirror.
Bathroom mirror.
We make them feel welcome in so many ways. Maybe that's why more business travelers stay with us than anyone else.
What I miss most is my children.
Holiday Inn. Stay with someone you know who really knows you.
A reminder from Walmart. No matter who you are, no matter what you drive, there's one sure way to get more out of it. Regular oil changes with quality Havoline motor oil. When you add Havoline, you add more life to your car. And with Walmart savings every day of the year, you're not only miles ahead, you're dollars ahead too. Saving money at Walmart. It's an idea that's really catching on. Walmart. Always the low price. Always.
Wednesday, it's every parent's nightmare. Your daughter's jilted boyfriend returns for revenge, then outwits the court.
Objection!
A must-see Law & Order NBC Wednesday.
The scoring drive for the Kansas City Chiefs, 8 plays, 94 yards, time consumed just over 5 minutes, and the touchdown pass from Dave Craig to Willie Davis, 50 yards. And now Nick Lowry will be kicking off with number 86, Arthur Marshall, and number 22, Alton Montgomery, the return man. Time remaining in the first half. It is very quiet here in Mile High State. From the goal line, here is Arthur Marshall on the return. And he is hit and down at the 17-yard line. And it was Benny Thompson who got it. And we'll be back with more of the Denver-Kansas City game in a moment.
The last thing the average person wants is the average car. That's why the new Mazda brought you the return of the pure sports car, the all-new RX-7. And the return of the Roadster, the Miata. That's why our 626 feels personal. And our MX-6 feels timeless. It's why every Mazda will fulfill its promise in a way no other car can.
Nipper and Chipper show us what the RCA home theater with SRS sound looks like. Now they show us what it feels like. Looks like. Feels like. Looks like. Feels like. Any questions?
Slowing down, that ain't you. No, no, that's not you.
Another look at the Thompson tornado.
Many times I like to look at number 46 making tackles on special teams. Benny Thompson, an outstanding plan B acquisition from the Detroit Lions. They got him to do just this thing, to come down and make plays inside the 20. Bang! Didn't have a chance. Had a little bit of problem there with the shoulder. But this is how this man makes his living. And more, it looks like he hurt himself celebrating a little bit.
Yeah, he's all right. He's a pinch nerve. It's okay. Yeah.
But more and more in the National Football League, people like this are staying in the league, even if they can't start, because of their ability to cover. And Benny Thompson shows right there that, like his namesake for the New York Giants, who made his name, Rene Thompson is a special teamer. He's doing an outstanding job with the Chiefs.
Denver trailing 7-0. First down now from their own 17-yard line. And Sharp in motion. Almost breaks it. Cool, he picks up 10. Let's go back to the Kansas City touchdown.
Key to this play is the play action. Watch Dennis Smith start to look into the backfield a little bit and come up here. And then he's going to try and turn to run at the last minute, and it's not going to be there. Willie Davis is going to run to the post, and it's going to be unoccupied. Dennis is the one that has to be back here, and the result is a great play action fake by Craig, and then the throw enables him to get a touchdown. Turns to run, and that's too late.
And a perfect pass.
It was. You know, Dave Craig has a reputation for being the quarterback who can only be successful on a team that has a running game. Get a chance to show you a little bit later a graphic of the number of great people that he has passed in his career. But I think he would be the first to say that he doesn't want to be known as a quarterback that all they can do is hand off and not get you beat. I played too many games against Dave Craig to know that he can do more than just that.
And as you saw, it is a first down for Denver. 11:43, time remaining in the second quarter. So the Denver Broncos have now played the last 10 quarters without scoring a touchdown.
That certainly has to have Dan Reeves concerned. The offense just isn't putting out what it should have.
Play action fake by Elway. And the pass is complete to Mark Jackson. and a first down. So back-to-back first downs for the Broncos. Kevin Ross with the tackle.
One thing that has been impressive, though, about the Denver Broncos thus far is the pass protection. Play action freezes them a little bit, but look at this. Plenty of time to throw. Fairly deep out right there by Mark Jackson. Mark Jackson on the comeback route. Kevin Ross turned around a little bit. He breaks to the ball, but a little bit too late. Elway puts it right on the money.
When we talked with John yesterday, Elway said, I'm holding the ball a little bit longer. I'm really not that confident of the routes that my receivers are running, and I'm not throwing on the break. I'm waiting until after the break.
His two key receivers the last couple of years have been Michael Young and Vance Johnson. Of course, both of them got hurt early in the season. Michael Young still on injured reserve, able to come off after next week. And Vance Johnson is off of injured reserve, but I would imagine, Charlie, that he will contribute little today.
Reggie Rivers picking up four on the play. Tracy Simeon with the tackle at the 44-yard line, and it's going to be second down and six. And there is Vance Johnson, number 82. They said with that shoulder surgery that he had on July the 28th that he would miss eight games, and he said, no way. And he missed four, and he's back for the fifth. And in drive in motion, Elway to throw. And he's throwing this one away as Derek Thomas was in pursuit.
You want to see how fast somebody 6'3", 242 pounds can go? Watch number 58 come in. This is normal speed. Now, right here, John Elway knows that he can't outrun Derek Thomas. And being the savvy veteran that he is, he just throws the ball out of bounds. A lot of times the quarterback will see the guy pursuing him and take his time, knowing that the guy doesn't have the speed to catch up. For sure, Elway out the corner of his eye saw, ooh, 58. I know what that means.
When we talked to the Bronco coaches, they all mentioned that Derek Thomas is the kind of player that makes you change your game plan. You always have to account for it.
And there's very few in the National Football League that are like that. Pat Swilling comes to mind. LT in the open.
Sharp has it first down. Shannon Sharp's third reception of the ball game. Charles Vinci with the tackle.
Well, here we are talking about Derek Thomas and the fact that he alters your offensive scheme. Take a look at what they do here with Derek Thomas. They line up the tight end to that side. He gets bumped a little bit. Not only is Freeman there, but Reggie Rivers is there as well. Effectively triple teamed on that play, enabling John Elway to complete the pass to Sharp for the first down.
And, of course, it is the left tackle, the rookie free agent, Russell Freeman, at 6'7", now 290 pounds, that is across from Derek Thomas. It's going to be a long afternoon.
But as we talked to him yesterday, he didn't seem to be too bothered by it.
No, he was looking forward to it. Elway with good protection. Throw it complete. And it's Shannon Sharp again. And another first down. The Broncos are on the move.
Third catch for Shannon Sharp. Fourth catch, excuse me. He might find himself there in position to play some more tight end. They need some pass catching out of that position. Settling down in the middle of the field in the seam. Goes up and makes the catch. Once again, excellent protection by the Denver Broncos. Here's Sharp in the middle of the field, floating in the zone. Goes up and catches the ball, comes down. First down, Broncos.
Now with Greg Lewis and Reggie Rivers in the backfield, and a first down at the Kansas City 33-yard line. Chiefs lead at 7-0, 8:40, time remaining first down. Here's the draw. Reggie Rivers. There's nothing there.
Part of the reason for there being nothing there is that Clarence Kay matched up against Neil Smith as a one-sided advantage for the Kansas City Chiefs. Neil Smith, number 90, as we mentioned earlier with the sack. Watch the tackle come off of him. In fact, it's Wydell. Excuse me, it wasn't Clarence Kay. Smith able to come off of Wydell and make the play, and the ball pops loose, but evidently he was down. The officials didn't see it.
And they mark it at the 36-yard line. It'll be second down and 13.
Neil Smith was talking about how he still has a chip on his shoulder from the old days when he was the second pick of the draft back in 1988, and everybody talked about what an underachiever he is. He said that to this day, that still bothers him, and that keeps him hungry.
Second and 13, Elway. That's a lateral. It's complete to Rivers. Rivers to the 30, the 25, inside the 20, and another first down. Benny Thompson with the tackle. They're going to mark it at about the 18-yard line. No, the 19.
Okay, the screen is set up well, but how many quarterbacks backs of the National Football League would have had the athletic ability to do this. Inside of your screen, he knows the screen's coming. He steps up right at the last minute, just flicks it over to Rivers, and the screen is set up well. Good blocking downfield, enabling Rivers to get inside the 20 and set up the Broncos.
That's almost a move of a zone. Almost a move of a point guard. He's looking one way, and he just flips it the other way, and the play goes on.
He drew everybody to him and dished it off.
First down at the 19-yard line. Gaston Green back in the offensive set, and he carries. And he is down. Saliamuro got him. They're going to mark it at the 20-yard line, a loss of one. So it is second down and 11.
Saliamuro took Keith Kartz, the center, with him. Watch as it ends up in the backfield. You see number 72 come off. Now 72 is going to be in the backfield. Saliamuro pushes him so far back. He's got both of them right there. He has both the runner and Kartz in the backfield. Great play by the former construction worker who now has established himself as a near Pro Bowl nose guard.
And also for 5 years, he's been teaching with the Samoan dance that we were working on in the lobby of the hotel. And he said, you still don't have it, Charlie.
No kidding. The inspiration for White Man Can't Dance. Well, there's the first rookie mistake we had. Bill Moss over Russell Freeman gets him to jump.
False start on the offense prior to the snap, number 68. 5-yard penalty. It remains second down.
We'll take another look at it. And as you take a look at it, when we talk with Russell Freeman, we ask him, of course, the first question is, what about Derek Thomas? And he said, Derek Thomas looks like Carl Lewis to me.
Yeah, that's right. We asked him what it looked like on film. Of course, I should say Russell Freeman's not alone. He looks like Carl Lewis to a lot of them.
Second and 16, playing right into the hands of Elway. Just has more room to throw. Scrambles out, and he's got the ball. Derek Thomas got him.
Well, Derek Thomas got him, but they did a good job actually protecting. That's heads up on the part of Thomas to contain John Elway. Once again, watch what the Denver Broncos do. The tight end lines up onto the left side. He has to go all the way outside. And both Reggie Rivers and Russell Freeman are on Derek Thomas. Once he scrambles out, Thomas sees that and tackles Elway for a minimal gain. Look, tight end bumps him there. Russell Freeman there. Reggie Rivers right behind him. There's no way the Denver Broncos are going to let number 58 beat them in the pass rush.
They're down in 14. Rivers, the remaining back. Elway, of course, will be throwing. Pressure from the backside, and the pass is incomplete. They were setting up a little screen to Reggie Rivers, and John just overthrew him.
Not just that, Charlie. Neil Smith, number 90, did a good job of reading it. Inevitably, when you screen to that side, you will have the right tackle cut the defensive end. But Neil Smith did not buy it. He forced the screen to go awry. Disappointed, overthrew him. Bad throw on the part of Elway, but good job by number 90 and Chris Martin on that side breaking up the screen pass.
David Treadwell is in from the 31-yard line. A field goal attempt of 41 yards. Tommy Maddox, the new holder, starting last week. And Treadwell hit 4 of 4. Keith Kartz with the snap. Here it is. And it is good. From 41 yards away. The score, Kansas City 7 and Denver 3. Back with the kickoff in a moment.
This is a big car. Put it in park.
Hey, how's it going?
It's going great.
Where's my food?
I love this place.
You know, you could have got the Chris sandwich for 99 cents.
I didn't want that. I wanted this.
That's a smart move, then, so you're having it your way.
99 cent Chris sandwich.
Chris sandwich, Chris sandwich, Chris sandwich.
Can you do that?
Yeah, but it's called a Chris sandwich. Check in between the seats. You could reach down in there and find enough change to pay for it. You got the Chris sandwich? Is that your favorite thing to get?
Yeah.
It's your way right away.
Love this place.
Get in line. Stay in step. Or maybe you'd rather go your own way. In which case, check out the all-new 93626 ES from the new Mazda. The company that's put a twist on everything from luxury cars to roadsters. Now we've done the same to sedans. With a V6, an airbag, and ABS. Introducing the all-new Mazda 626.
Mazda, it just feels right.
Weekend.
No tie.
No briefcase.
Just plastic.
It all boils down to this.
No other card you can carry is accepted in more places and in more ways.
Food.
At home and abroad.
Okay. I got it.
Then MasterCard. It's the only card you need.
Rooms.
MasterCard.
Not a bad day's work.
Master the moment.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Burger King, where you can get it your way right away at Burger King now. By MasterCard. Master the moment with a card that's accepted at nearly 10 million places worldwide. By the new Mazda. Mazda, it just feels right. And by Coors Light. The silver bullet is the right beer now.
With 5 minutes and 10 seconds left to go in the first half, kicking off is Brad Daloiseau of the Denver Broncos. They carry three kickers, and you will see the reason. He has booted 12 of 14 kickoffs into the end zone or beyond. And Dan, you said it's a comforting feeling to have him kick off. And Daloiseau does it again. Can you believe that? And he is the perfect kicker. He kicks right. He throws left. He bats left. He writes right, plays golf the other way. Back in a moment.
Why can't van doors swing open instead of slide? Why do minivans handle like trucks? Why can't they feel more like a car? This is what the engineers at Mazda wondered when they designed the MPV. Because when you ask better questions, you tend to come up with better answers.
Why does your door do that?
The MPV from the new Mazda.
It just feels like...
A noble warrior advised, the art of protection springs from within. One must stay vigilant against one's unfragrant perspiration, lest one provoke a hostile response. Thus, the Norris Ritual is Rygaard Sports Stick. An aromatic array of the freshest scents and maximum protection against disarming wetness.
Confirming the wisdom, the best defense... Not to offend.
Right guard sports stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
Only Delta gives you more flights from over here to over there. Only Delta flies you nonstop to more cities from over here to over there. In fact, only Delta flies you nonstop to more cities in Europe than all these airlines combined. Delta. We love to fly, and it shows the world over.
Tonight, a streetwise agent's life is in jeopardy.
Kidnapping a federal agent's about as ugly as it can get.
Based on the actual case.
Where is she now?
An all-new Secret Service. Then, you'll eyewitness the climax of a dangerous manhunt and feel the heat of danger in a Hellfighter Spectacular Video Diary. An all-new eyewitness video after Secret Service NBC Tonight.
Dale Carter, rookie kick returner, is not used to this kind of distance from a kicker. Bach catches him right on top of the head. Brad Daloiseau pumping one a good 70, 75 yards. Now he's 13 out of 15 with touchbacks on his kickoffs.
Kansas City first down their own 20-yard line. Fred, the throw-up first down pass is complete over the middle to Todd McNair. When everybody expects the Chiefs to come out running, they come out throwing. And they have the first down just shy of the 35-yard line. Next Sunday, NBC Sports presents an action-packed NFL doubleheader beginning at 12:30 Eastern Time with NFL Live, Seattle-Dallas, Pittsburgh-Cleveland, Buffalo and the Raiders, Houston and Cincinnati. That is all next Sunday here on NBC. First down, Kansas City. Is complete for the first down.
Boy, Dennis Smith got lucky. Man, oh man, did he get lucky.
Todd McNair has the reception at the 43. The
reason I'm saying that is Dennis Smith has him man for man. Watch him come up and go for the interception and just completely miss it. Watch number 49. Oh no. Now if he doesn't stumble right there, good thing of that water jumps on top of him. Todd McNair, now that's his 18th catch of the season. He leads the Kansas City Chiefs in receptions, which is very surprising because none of the other wide receivers up to this point, except for Fred Jones, in double figures.
And Barry Williams. Meanwhile, that offensive line of the Kansas City Chiefs, they just continue their opportunity. They say we show up on Sunday, we do our job, and that should be enough. When we talked with Dave Zott yesterday, he said, you know, nobody even knows about us. And we're doing such a great job, and nobody knows. And he said, you need a name. And so he said, all right, let me get on the phone. He said that Grunhardt, he'll come up with a name. Grunhardt, Tim Grunhardt, the center, called us in our meeting and said, we're the Forgotten Five. And here's why. Last 3 years, 1,000-yard rusher. Last 2 seasons, allowed just 43 sacks. Third fewest in the NFL. The Forgotten Five. We continue that, of course, by beginning to put up the money. There's Barry Word, and he goes outside. Wyman Henderson was the man who was chasing him.
Well, the thing that surprises me about that, here you get a chance to look at the names, is that of those statistics, particularly the 1,000-yard rushers, maybe it's because those names aren't easy to remember. And, of course, Dave Zott made that point. I said, well, partner, I said, if there's anybody on the line who has an easy name to remember, it would probably be you. You know, you could call yourself Dave Hotshot or something. I mean, something along that line. You know, they need the Hogs or some other moniker. Maybe this has started. Who knows?
Third down. Six at the 48-yard line, so the Forgotten Five has their work cut out on third down, as does Grant. That throws over the middle and was incomplete. He was off target. Perry, the intended receiver, Smith had the coverage. It'll be fourth down.
Good pressure by Mike Kroll, too, as he comes into the backfield. Watch the left of your screen. Mike Kroll is going to come on the loop. Now they push inside, and there it is right there in the middle of the field. He has to adjust a little bit, throw off his back foot. Couldn't get enough juice on it, and Dennis Smith breaks it up.
So Brian Barker will be kicking. Arthur Marshall is the return man. About 11 yards on the play to the 21-yard line. The score is Kansas City 7, Denver 3. Back in a moment.
Silver Thunder!
Ooh, silver time, silver line, girl in the silver suit looks so fine.
Looks so fine.
Silver box, silver top, silver fish, silver wish come from here, right from here.
What it can do to the outside of your car. Weak, neglected antifreeze can do to the inside. You need the tough anti-corrosion formula of Prestone. Use fresh Prestone every year to give your radiator and cooling systems heavy-duty rust and corrosion protection. No matter what happens to the outside, Prestone protects the inside. Prestone stops the rust that stops your car.
While the fluid styling of the Mazda 929 may be timeless, this generous offer from Mazda is considerably shorter. Now you can lease the 929, complete with dual airbags, anti-lock brakes, and European leather, for just $349 per month. So see your Mazda dealer today. Like all good things, this offer must soon come to an end.
With the NFL's top offense, Kelly and company have their sights set on a third straight AFC championship, the Raiders. Their trouncing by the Bills in the championship game 2 years ago still has the silver and black seeing red. Now they clash again. An NBC football doubleheader next Sunday.
Before we get to next week's doubleheader, be sure to stay with us at halftime for the Domino Pizza NFL Live Halftime Report. With these three gentlemen, of course, Bob Costas, Will McDonough, and Bill Parcells, and a special report on Bill Walsh at his victory over Notre Dame yesterday. All right, Denver goes to work at their own 22-yard line, first down, with 2 minutes and 15 seconds left to go in the first half. And here's Gaston Green to the 25-yard line. And as we move towards the 2-minute mark, look at the last two possessions by the Broncos, 14 plays in the punt, and then 12 plays on the drive, and it ended with a field goal. 2-minute warning, Kansas City 7, Denver 3. We'll be back to Mile High Stadium in a moment.
Liberty Mutual Insurance presents Legends of the Game. In a career which rewrote the record book, this quarterback led the Redskins to the NFL championship as a rookie. But in his storybook career, the chapters kept getting better. A triple threat, he led the NFL in punting and interceptions in 1943. Who was this legend?
Back when all anyone could talk about was how fast cars could go, Liberty Mutual was thinking about how safe cars could be. So we began research on the safety belt, airbag, and anti-lock brakes.
There were two persons injured and one killed. The dead was James Byron Dean.
Sammy Baugh entered the record books and the Hall of Fame by leading the NFL in passing six times. A true legend of the game.
Take one and action.
Hey, what's the best thing about breakfast at McDonald's?
Coffee.
Pour it out of the cup. It's steaming. It's dark and rich.
I pour it personally.
Coffee fresh?
Fresh fruit. Fantastic cup of coffee.
So what's the secret?
Arabica.
Oh, what's an Arabica?
Arabica beans.
Oh, the beans. And what else?
It's always fresh.
It just tastes good.
And they like to come in and talk with each other, and just like the small coffee shop long ago.
How much a coffee refill?
They're free.
What you want is what you get.
It's guaranteed.
Want some?
Yeah.
The Denver Broncos have not scored a touchdown in the last 10 quarters.
Charlie, interesting, when we talked with John Elway yesterday, he pointed out the fact that a lot of that is because they're not even on the field. He said that when they played the Raiders earlier in the season, they only had like 50 plays in the last couple of games. They have not had a situation where they've had 70-plus plays.
Not true today, though. Their time of possession, 7 minutes more than Kansas City. It's almost 7.5 minutes more than Kansas City.
Well, that's certainly a credit to the chief defense.
Denver's had the ball 17 minutes and 49 seconds. Kansas City 10 minutes, 11 seconds. Kansas City leads 7-3. Elway steps out of the pocket. And he throws a maybe pass. He was past the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, two flags went right down.
Yeah.
I got to tell you, I have to laugh. Yes. Yesterday, they were talking about how they weren't going to make that big of a deal out of Derek Thomas. They weren't going to help him. I've been watching every single rush. There's been at least two people on Derek Thomas.
Well, yes, they said we cannot make an adjustment.
Yeah, we can't make a big deal out of it. Yeah, right.
You better,
illegal forward pass on the offense number 7. He threw the pass from beyond the line of scrimmage. Penalty carries a loss of down and 5-yard penalty. It brings up third down.
There's the line of scrimmage right there. Not too tough. It's a 25-yard line. Now when he throws the ball, let's see where his feet are. Flush out of the pocket, he heads forward. Now it looks right here, for all intents and purposes, that he's going to run. There, completely over the line. Right here, his feet completely over. Here's the line that he's got to be passed. Easy call for the official. Good job.
And it is a loss of down penalty. The 5 yards back to the 20. And it is third down and 12. And Elway from the shotgun. And he's right on his mark of 7 of 14. He's been hitting only 50%.
He calls timeout because this will be an interesting decision here as to whether or not they want to see if they go for the first down, because obviously if they go for it and it's incomplete, then that saves Kansas City a timeout. Probably here, I think Dan Reeves would say that they'll spread them out, run a drop play, or do something where the ball is on the ground and force Kansas City to use their timeouts.
Also, another interesting note at this moment, with 1 minute and 47 seconds left to go in the first half. More apropos, of course, at the end of the ball game. But to a man, every Kansas City Chief that we talked to yesterday talked about Elway, the two-minute man. The two-minute man, you've got to be aware of the fact that he can kill you. He'll hang around and keep it close. We need to put it away before there's 2 minutes left in the ballgame.
And that's that statistic right there that you see in front of you. Dan Marino also has 20 fourth quarter comebacks. I believe Joe Montana has like 18 and Staubach has 17. So, you know, as confident, you're right, as confident as the Kansas City Chief players sounded, to a man, they said, but we don't want it to come into the last 2 minutes.
That's right. And interesting to mention that word, I saw more confidence in Denver with this Kansas City Chief ball club than I've ever seen them express in this city playing the Broncos.
I agree.
Elway's going to be hit from behind the ball. If they catch, pick it off inbounds, do they have it in time? And we have two players down back at the 10-yard line. Smith is down for Kansas City, and he is up.
Now the officials are over.
And that's Russell Freeman.
Now the officials are over talking about whether or not he intentionally fumbled at four, but I don't think so. I believe it was either Saliamu or Griffin that stripped the ball from him, and that's why the ball went forward. And so what they're talking about is that evidently
the ball was fumbled forward by number seven out of bounds. By rule, it returns to the spot of the fumble, fourth down.
So Kansas City the opportunity to recover it. And they were unable to. It goes out of bounds, comes back to the spot.
Now, he's not going to argue this too vehemently. Watch right there, Saliamu. He gets the ball away from him, but as the rule states, inside the last 2 minutes, you can't fumble the ball forward. So the officials are on top of that, making the Broncos punt here on their own 16-yard line. And Kansas City will have excellent field position. And right here, Charlie, you just saw Russell Freeman coming off. Who's going to play left tackle now? That was a rookie free agent. Now they're really going to have to shuffle their offensive line.
It could be another rookie, Chuck Johnson. Probably they'll move Dave Wydell over there, just guessing.
Well, Jeff Davidson, their left guard, of course, played some left tackle for them last year, and there's a possibility they could move him out.
But they move him out and move Dave Wydell at guard. Of course, we will be finding that out in the second half as we have a timeout with 1:38. A lot of time remaining in the first half as, with any kind of a punt return, Kansas City with good field position and Nick Lowry, the field goal kicker.
You know, Charlie, I really was surprised that they threw there. Third and 12. You don't come up with third and 12 too often. I'm surprised they didn't just go with the drop play, get tackle for a 6-yard gain, let the clock run and force them to use their timeouts. Now, of course, Kansas City still has their timeouts remaining. And as you mentioned, more than likely, they're going to have outstanding field position. And I know Dan Reeves, his thinking here was probably the fact that, well, you know, if we do that, they have enough timeouts. But still, you run the risk, as you saw there, of a fumble or a sack or a lot of different things could happen. And third and 12, you know, that's not something you come up with too often.
Mike Horan to kick. Dale Carter is the return man. And he gets a good one off, and it hangs. And it's taken at the 30-yard line. Was out to the 41. There's a flag dropped at the 44, and then he cut back to about the 38. Reggie Johnson got it. And we'll check out the marker. 54 yards on the kick by Horan. 9 yards on the return by Dale Carter. And the penalty flag.
The field position we talked about earlier evidently isn't going to come to fruition. Great punt by Horan, and now a penalty tacked on. Now the Kansas City Chiefs will wonder aloud whether or not they're going to go through their two-minute drill now that they're upset.
Holding on the receiving team number 84. It was a post-possession foul, 10-yard penalty.
That's on Will
Davis. The penalty will be enforced from the end of the kick. The receiving team will keep the ball first down.
Russell Freeman trying to get that leg back in shape. We'll get a chance to see. You're going to watch right at the bottom of you, right here. Take a look at the left leg and what happens to it and how it gets bent back. Actually, it's Neil Smith on the other side. See, it's trapped right there. Right there. Can we come back? Can we come back and take a look at it? Right here. Look at the angle right here where it's trapped. Look at as the knee bends in. That's a medial. That could be either a medial collateral. That could be a shin. But that's unfortunate because Neil Smith came out of nowhere to get his leg, and that was certainly unintentional.
And hope it's a shin.
Yeah, exactly.
Kansas City from their own 22-yard line, first down. And here's Todd McNair. Out to the 28-yard line. And the time remaining in the first half. Kansas City with the lead, 7-3. Bit of a hurry up offense.
A couple of weeks ago against the Houston Oilers, Todd McNair was the big star enabling them to get to the overtime. Right there, Craig, right on top of calling timeout after that completion.
At the 36-yard line to Willie Davis.
But McNair, both in catches and in draw plays, got them down the field. And as you know, Charlie, because we've done a number of games there, one of the most difficult places to win in the National Football League is in the Astrodome. But Craig, the man who everybody says is good with just the running game, engineered a terrific two-minute drive, enabling them to tie even though they lost in overtime.
Kansas City with one timeout remaining. They would like to save that timeout for their field goal attempt if possible. And be sure to stay with us for the Domino Pizza NFL Live halftime report with Bob Costas, Will McDonough, Bill Parcells, and a special report on Bill Walsh and his victory Stanford over Notre Dame yesterday. And they came from what? They were down, what, 16 to nothing?
27 unanswered points is what Stanford did.
Yeah.
And very, very impressive. I guess
he's back to being the genius again.
Yeah, okay, great.
Is there room for two in this world?
Bill and I, sure.
Bruised left calf. Bruised left calf. The report on Russell Freeman. Good news for the Broncos. First down from the 36-yard line. Underneath the coverage, the pass is complete to him.
Jones came back and just absolutely poleaxed Tyrone Braxton. Crossing route. Oh, goodness.
And he is hurt. They're signaling for the Raiders quickly to come across the field.
Oh, my. Braxton just never saw him coming. Underneath route to Emile Harry, and Jones comes from the other side, and he just never sees him. Watch right here at the top. Jones is going to come back, and he's going to come all the way back. I mean, this is going to be a vicious shot. Nothing illegal about it. His head's in front. Bang! Down he goes. Now, look at the excitement of the Kansas City Chiefs. Here's another look at it. Now, watch when the Chief players come out. Watch these players come out right here, all excited about that's the way to hit people. Look at that excitement. And Schottenheimer, see, now, right here to me, that's a class act right there. Marty Schottenheimer knows that a player is hurt and is waving the people over there to take a look at it.
And his trainers, of course, the Kansas City trainers, are there immediately. And Marty wasn't kidding us yesterday. He talked about Fred Jones and his blocking ability, wasn't he?
Well, again, in that situation, that's pretty easy when the guy doesn't see you coming. And Fred Jones right there. Look at him kneeling down right here. Look at Fred Jones. Very concerned. He wants to put a big hit on somebody. He wants to make the play, but he certainly doesn't want anybody to get hurt. And look at this right here. He comes over to say something to him. He said, look, all right. Everything's square. I like that. That's real sportsmanship as he crosses himself and says, thank goodness Tyrone Braxton's okay.
Now we're going to take a look at that hit one more time. Now this is at full speed, not slow motion.
You think this game isn't physical? Watch here in the middle of your screen. Watch from the top. Watch number 80 come back. Full speed. Yow.
Ooh.
Look at the reaction of his teammates right there. But once they, you know what I thought, what was classy about that? They're excited for the hit. Players are like that. They like to see the big hit. But the minute they saw that Braxton might have been a little bit hurt, all of a sudden they all rallied to his aid. I like that. That's class.
52 seconds left to go in the first half. It'll be second and three. Kansas City at their own 43-yard line.
Now you wonder how affected Freddie Jones is going to be in this drive. You know, maybe his mind is on that a little bit. He saw a collision before the ball, but Dennis Smith was going for the football. He anticipated that well. He was completely going for the football, as you're going to get a chance to see here on the replay. He goes up and he is going after the ball. He is not going for the collision. Watch number 49. Watch the middle of your screen. Watch him going after the football. He's going for the catch. And in going for the ball, both men have equal right to the ball, and that's collision right there. That's not a good call by the official.
That is a terrible call by the official, because once that ball is up, equal rights as a receiver, the defender and the offensive player, and he was going for the ball. You're absolutely right.
And Charlie, you and I have seen enough games to know that if that's reversed, if number 86 is on defense and number 49 is on offense, the exact same play, they would not call it.
Here's the referee. He's going to make a statement.
Pass interference on the defense, number 49. First down.
Bad call. Wait for Kansas City. 45 seconds left to go in the first half, and you hate to see a game of this magnitude turn on a call by the officials. We'll look one more time.
What's the intent? What's 49 doing? He collides with him. He is going after the ball. He had plenty of time to look and see the interception. Hopefully after this play, if we have the time, if we can get a side shot from the view, you can see number 49 going after the ball completely. But if not, it suffices us to see that number 49, Dennis Smith, wanted the football. He was not colliding with anybody.
First down, 24-yard line. Pass is caught at the 14-yard line by J.J. Burden. They're going to run it incomplete. I thought he had it at the 14. Clock is stopped now with 41 seconds left in the first half.
Good call by the official. There's the ball laying on the ground. That's a no-brainer.
Jumping back against the offensive charge, which is legal by the defense. That'll go against Kansas City.
You know, what's interesting about this, Charlie, is yesterday when we had a chance to have a conversation with Dan Reeves, he was mentioning how he doesn't like...
False start prior to the snap on the offense, number 77. 5-yard penalty, it remains second down.
He mentioned how he didn't like the fact that the crowd noise could affect the offenses. I would guess that he's not thinking that right now. He likes very much the fact that the crowd is getting into the game and altering the count. Baldinger right here, he just flat out didn't hear it. He backed up. That's a good job there to get him to jump off. Difficult for tackles in the nickel offense because they're in space. They have to look in at the ball, which is what Baldinger's doing right now.
Craig throws. The pass is complete at the 20-yard line to Fred Jones. Out of bounds, stops the clock, 35 seconds left to go in the first half.
Well, I guess now we don't have to ask the question whether or not that big hit affected Fred Jones. He does a nice job of coming back to the ball and helping out his quarterback. Craig rolls to his left. He's in a little bit of trouble. Now watch, a receiver's taught to come back to him, come back to me. That's what he does. He comes back to the ball inside the 20 and heads up, gets out of bounds, and saves them a timeout.
Third down and six.
You see the mascot almost kick him? The mascot almost kicked him in the butt.
Don't fool with Fred. The ball is loose. Kansas City recovers at the 27-yard line. And the field goal team comes on. Clock is moving. 21 seconds and counting. It'll be from the 34, an attempt of 44 yards by Nick Lowry.
They have plenty of time. Look at Nick. He's a veteran player. Look at this. He's taking his time. He knows exactly how much time he has. Now he's ready. Now he says, go ahead. Oh, it's a veteran player.
Uh-oh. And he splits it from 44 yards away. No time remaining.
Look at Dan Reeves coming out to the official screaming right now. He can't believe that call. He can't believe that. He didn't let Dennis Smith go after the ball. That just cost him 3 points, and he knows it.
And I tell you what, at the this week, Dan Reeves will get a call from the commissioner's office, and they'll say they made a mistake.
And you saw Charlie Waters, former All-Pro safety of the Dallas Cowboys, now on the staff of Dan Reeves, the defensive back coach, trying to defend Dennis Smith. And as you can tell by the reaction of this crowd, they're not terribly happy about the way the first half ended.
So it is halftime, and the score is Kansas City 10 and Denver 3 in the battle for the number one spot in the AFC West. Now let's go to New York City and Bob Costas. Bob?
This is the Domino's Pizza NFL Live Halftime Report, brought to you by Domino's. Nobody knows like Domino's how you like pizza at home.
All right, with Will McDonough and Bill Parcells, Bob Costas in New York. The score at the half, despite Dan Reeves' anger, the Chiefs 10 and the Broncos 3. Now let's quickly zip through the rest of the scores. The Giants take a 10-0 lead at halftime against the Raiders. Jared Bunch has a 5-yard scoring run. Washington is up on Phoenix 17-0. They're at the half in Phoenix. Cardinals could go 0-4, could be their 12th consecutive regular season loss spread over two seasons. Seattle and San Diego. Humphreys throws a 67-yard touchdown pass to Anthony Miller, looking for their first win. The Chargers at home just before halftime, leading 10-3. San Francisco is in front 10-7 at Candlestick over the Rams at halftime. Jim Everett, however, completed all 9 passes he threw in the first half, one of them for a touchdown. Now, these are finals from earlier today. Miami shocks Buffalo in Buffalo, 37-10. Highlights from that game. People wondered how long it would take for Keith Jackson to make some sort of impact. Well, it was nearly immediate. Second quarter, following a Lewis Oliver interception of Jim Kelly, Dan Marino will scramble right. Jackson comes back to him to make himself available for the catch and then dives in for the TD. They go up 10-3. Jim Kelly intercepted for the second time in the first half. Four interceptions on him, all told for the day. J.B. Brown picking it off, brings it back 48 yards before Kelly nudges him out of bounds. Marino then hit Tony Page for a 17-3 lead, but they cut it to 17-10 as Andre Reed caught this one just before halftime. However, as soon as they got the ball at the start of the second half, Marino drove them 82 yards and capped it with this 9-yarder to Bobby Humphrey. It was 24-10 in favor of Miami. Trying to close to within a touchdown, Buffalo drives back down, but the pass into the end zone by Kelly is intercepted by Lewis Oliver again. Oliver had three of the four interceptions for the day. He brings it back 103 yards, tying Vince Glenn's NFL record for longest interception return for a score. He did it in 1987 when he was playing with San Diego. The 103-yard return made it 31-10. Then there were a couple of Pete Stoyanovich field goals, and they win it 37-10. Miami to 4-0, Buffalo 4-1. Huge victory for Don Shula. We'll talk more about it in a minute. Minnesota was trailing 20-0 in the fourth quarter, and they came back at home and beat the Bears 21-20 in an NFC Central matchup. Refrigerator Perry receiving help, tucking in his shirt there. A delightful scene from the NFL sidelines. Here's Harbaugh throwing into the end zone and a fine diving catch by Tom Waddle. At one point, as I said, Chicago had a 20-0 lead, but then Harbaugh, on an audible, makes a crucial mistake. His pass is intercepted by Todd Scott, who had three interceptions a week ago against Cincinnati for Minnesota. Brings this one back for the TD, and the Vikings are back alive at 20-7. And look how Ditka feels about this one as he reams Harbaugh along the sideline. They got another touchdown to pull within 20-14, and then they won the game on their final drive. The former 49er Roger Craig up and over from a yard out. The extra point wins at 21-20. What does Ditka think of it? Listen.
No, it's a loss. I mean, what the hell? It's a loss. What are you going to do? We just dug ourselves a big hole. Now we'll find out if we got enough character on this football team to get out of the hole. That's all. But I'm not, I would say this honestly in front of, if the situation arises again, there will be changes made, and they'll be definite, and they'll be permanent. That's all I'll say. Because I'm not going to put 47 guys' careers in the hand of somebody who thinks he knows more than I know. That's just the way I feel.
That's the reference to Harbaugh, who apparently checked off the play at the line of scrimmage in the fourth quarter with a 20-0 lead, threw a dangerous pass, intercepted, returned for a touchdown, and the game turned after that play, and Chicago coughs up the lead and loses 21-20. New Orleans beats Detroit in Detroit 13-7. Barry Sanders, 9 carries, held to just 37 yards. New Orleans is now 3-2, and Detroit off to a 1-4 start. Indianapolis wins at Tampa Bay. Jeff George returns, and after a tough first half, he was intercepted 3 times. He throws 2 touchdown passes, and Indy wins it 24-14. And Atlanta got 3 touchdown passes from Chris Miller, and they win at home over Green Bay. Both these clubs now 2-3. The final, the Falcons 24 and the Packers 10. Let's turn to Bill Parcells. How surprised are you by the Dolphins' victory? Not just the win, but the margin in Buffalo.
Oh, I'm surprised by the margin, without question. But I think this has to be the Dolphins' biggest win in 5 or 6 years. I think it's a win, the kind of win that can take a team and say, hey, we might be able to do this thing, and they seriously believe it. I think it's been a long time since the Dolphins thought that they could seriously take Buffalo out, but I think they might think so right now.
They could always score on them, but defensively they did something today they hadn't been able to do to Marv Levy's team in the past.
Yeah, a wonderful day for Lewis Oliver. 3 interceptions, he gets the game ball, but it had to be especially good against Miami. He couldn't even play against them a few years ago. They had to take him off the field because he couldn't match up with the Buffalo receivers. A great day of retribution for him.
Okay, coming up, we'll look back to Stanford's big win and Bill Walsh's strategy. We'll have Bill Parcells analyze it as Stanford upset Notre Dame yesterday. We do it following these messages from your local station.
He's an urban hood.
What a great day!
Hiding out in suburban hood.
Keep your nose clean. Capiche?
You trying to say capiche?
Steve Martin, Rick Moranis.
Enough of us here to start a crime wave.
The network premiere, My Blue Heaven, NBC tonight.
What a day for a mole, huh?
Secret pleasures come out of the back room into the courtroom.
Is this material offensive to you?
No.
When Mark Harmon tracks a porno killer, a provocative new Reasonable Doubts, NBC Tuesday.
Thank you.
driven to move mountains for this city, doing whatever it takes to push Denver's business to over 290 cities across the country and around the world. United and United Express, we'll move mountains for you. Come fly the friendly skies.
You need your brakes fixed, but your car dealer couldn't take you today? What's stopping you? Midas can fix your brakes right the same day you bring in your car. You need brakes, but you're worried about cost? What's stopping you? Right now, get $20 off any Midas brake service. You need brakes? What's stopping you? Midas will give you $20 off the price of any quality Midas brake service. Your brakes can't wait. Midas today.
Hi, I'm Dan Reeves. Watch the Broncos play on four.
This is the Domino's Pizza NFL Live Halftime Report, brought to you by Domino's. Nobody knows like Domino's how you like pizza at home.
With Will McDonough and Bill Parcells during this halftime segment, we're going to take a look back to what happened yesterday in South Bend, Indiana. True, it was a great win for Stanford, but it was also a great insight into Bill Walsh. This is one of the defining moments in his coaching career in his own terms. Even though he's won three Super Bowls, he talked about yesterday's game as one of the highlights of his entire career, and it had the hallmarks of the coaching style of Bill Walsh. They fall behind 16-0. His team doesn't panic. They come back, and they do it with an offensive package the likes of which the most college teams never have to face.
But it looks familiar to me, Bob. The first play is vintage 49er offense. You see the fullback, J.J. Lastly, sneaking underneath the Notre Dame blitz coverage. Steve Sindstrom, the quarterback, fakes the sweep, bootlegs out, eludes the rush just in time to get it to Lastly, who takes it in for a 20-16 Stanford lead.
Now, later, they're going to be up by 7. And Walsh has no time to celebrate. Notice how composed he'll be on the sideline as we get a look at him here. They got the ball at their own 20. They want to eat up some time, but they don't just want to plunge into the line, and he's got a creative way to approach that, too.
Well, this is vintage 49er power right here, the sweep. I can see Wendell Tyler running this, Linville Elliott running this from years back, and Sindstrom to Milburn here. Big gain in the last drive.
And here's Walsh after the game on this very play.
That's the bomb sweep that Sid Gilman developed in the early 60s. And that was a big part of our San Francisco offense and with other clubs I've worked with and been with. And the Glenn Milburn's ideal, and I don't think Leonard even seen the bomb sweep.
And the key to these drives, which won the game for them in the second half, the unorthodox mixing of the run and the pass, going to each when you'd least expect it. Certainly not by the textbook, but by his intuition and his preparation.
Well, four receivers strong, and they sneak the tight end back to the weak side. Sindstrom gets it to him, another big play.
Does it look familiar? Maybe it should. This is from the 81 NFC title game, the legendary win over Dallas. Here's Montana on the late drive, finding Freddie Solomon here that set them up for the winning TD pass to Dwight Clark. And then here's the sweep. Here's that so-called Bob sweep, and a guy whose name you mentioned, Linville Elliott, gets it here.
Looks familiar to me. There they go with good power, guards out in front, knocking the Dallas defenders down. Here's the same thing yesterday, Milburn, same sweep, in for the easy touchdown.
And Walsh allowing himself a moment of quiet celebration on the sideline. Just for those of you who might be curious, Bob sweep, back, fullback, on backer, linebacker. He is not that surprised, based on a conversation you had with him this summer, not that surprised that he was able to beat
Notre
Dame. That's
right. I think he was very confident he could beat Notre Dame, Bob. I talked with him. He visited the Olympics. We talked one night, and I asked him about his schedule, and he says, yeah, we'll win about 89 games, and we're going to beat a couple of teams people don't think we can beat. And I said, who? He said, Notre Dame. And when he came in, you know, big underdog yesterday, I think it was just what he wanted. He was confident against Notre Dame that he could score against their defense.
The other thing is, these defensive coordinators, these young guys in college football, they better start watching some film because they're not going to catch up with Bill Walsh in 3 weeks film exchange. They got to go back 5, 6, 7 years, see what he did out there. That's vintage 49er stuff we're seeing.
How would you prepare for him? I realize you didn't play him that often, not being in the same division.
We played him enough to satisfy me. We played him 7 or 8 times, and we would go back and look at what they attacked us with only and not look at the attack on other teams in our division or in the conference.
Like you say, not many college coaches will have faced the sort of package, which obviously doesn't have the same sort of personnel, but it's the same idea, it's the same overview that he brought to the 49ers.
Well, they don't have the pass defense scheme in college football that Walsh is used to attacking, so this is kind of elementary stuff for the Stanford offense right now.
Okay, and we continue following these messages from your local stations.
Tuesday.
I want a divorce.
Sam's mission is to save a marriage until another woman steals his heart.
I hope I'm not interrupted.
It's A Heart Divided on Quantum Leap, NBC Tuesday. Wednesday. It's every parent's nightmare when your daughter's jilted boyfriend returns for revenge.
What is it with your daughter?
Share the outrage when he outwits the courts.
I'll take my chances with the jury.
USA Today calls it miles above the best.
Objection!
A must-see Law & Order, NBC Wednesday. Drop into a Dodge dealer now and you can get a Ram 150 pickup with over $2,600 in package savings, plus $1,500 cash back. Or get a Cummins diesel and get $500 cash back. $500, that's something Dodge hardly ever drops on diesel pickups. It's the National Dodge Truck Sale, now arriving at a Dodge dealer near you.
The Dan Reeves Show, Monday night at 6:30, only on News 4.
His name was Craig. In getting to know him, I learned he came from a single-parent home. No brothers, and he had no father. But he had a lot of emotional problems, so I became his buddy. I know how a child like Craig feels. When I was only 5 years old, back in 1972, my father, Air Force Captain Robert Thomas, was shot down when his plane was returning from a mission in Vietnam. When I lost him, I felt I'd lost everything in the world. But in the short time we were together, he inspired me to be the best my heart and mind could make me. I'm Derek Thomas of the Kansas City Chiefs, and I know there's a tremendous need for special one-on-one mentoring, particularly for young black males, to fill the role of a father, a counselor, a friend. I'm just one of the NFL players that have joined the United Way to help save children at risk.
Your local United Way, helping where help is needed most. This message furnished by the National Football League.
Here in Denver, the Coors Light halftime statistics, Todd.
Very impressive on the part of the Chiefs offensively. Barry Wirtz averaging 7 yards per carry. And Dave Craig in the first half was 8 for 11. Very impressive.
Good. And Denver will be kicking off to start the second half with Dale Carter, the deep back, on the return. Todd McNair and Fred Jones are off on the wings. And Del Russo does it again.
It's good.
It's good. Boy, does he have a look.
You know, I know that this is a novel thing, and that's all well and good, but I wonder if they can justify keeping three kickers on the roster, because, you know, that certainly hurts your versatility. Big play there at the end of the first half, of course, is the interference, and the debate, actually, I had a lot of people have their own opinion regarding this that came up to me. Is he going after the ball, and does he go through the receiver to get it? Well, there is contact, certainly, but it appeared that Dennis Smith and Dan Reeves doesn't... isn't questioning what it should have been, nor is Charlie Waters. You can see Steve Atwater pulling his coach back because he doesn't want him to get thrown out of the game. Charlie, a couple of years ago when I was playing here, we had coaches argue so vehemently at halftime that we started off having to kick off from the 20 because we had a 15-yarder.
Kansas City comes out throwing to Willie Davis, and he is across the 40-yard line to about the 42. Dennis Smith was there for the Denver Broncos.
That certainly caught the Denver Broncos off guard. Everybody just assumed they're going to hand the ball to Word and do what they normally do. Stepping out, three-step drop, just a comeback. Breaks the tackle right there of Charles Dimery and cuts up the field. Of course, Dimery replacing Tyrone Braxton, who, of course, took that bruising hit there near the end of the first half.
And a gain of 23 yards to the 43-yard line. First down, Kansas City. The Chiefs lead at 10-3. Simon Fletcher makes the tackle. It'll be second down and 9. Kansas City in the first half had the ball four times. They punted twice, scored a touchdown, and that field goal by Nick Lowry from 44 yards away coming as time expired in the first half.
Speaking of Nick Lowry, I had a chance as I went to get a drink at halftime to talk with Carl Peterson. And of course, Nick Lowry has only missed one field goal this year in nine attempts, and that was a 20-yarder against the Houston Oilers. And he said it was because he didn't have enough time to do his routine. I said, wait a minute, the clock was 15 seconds and running. He had plenty of time to do his routine. Now, how did he justify that one?
Tyrone Braxton in on defense for Denver. The pass is complete at the 40-yard line to J.J. Burden. And a flag comes flying, followed by two more.
That is just total frustration on the part of the Denver Broncos. An excellent throw once again by Dave Craig. Right in the middle, personal foul.
They'll add 15 yards to the play.
Dennis Smith is the man who's going to have the hit. And, of course, Dennis Smith is the one they called for the interference earlier. Now watch here at the
personal
end of the play.
Personal foul on the defense, number 49.
Makes the tackle. Now watch, he's going to spike
right
and fall off.
15-yard penalty.
Wrestling Federation kind of takedown there by Dennis Smith. Certainly frustrated by the events at the end of the first half. But a 12-year veteran like Dennis shouldn't lose his poise like this. Certainly he's obviously down. There's no reason he had to do to spike him on top of his head. Burden was lucky he didn't get hurt.
However, you do have to admire the fact that he picked up 170 pounds of football player, plus the equipment, took him over his shoulder. Not a bad move. Shouldn't have done it, but not a bad move.
Admiration's not the word I'd use there. Lack of composure.
The Denver 22-yard line, first down. Play action fake. Craig scrambles. Flags are down everywhere. Pass is completed. The 6-yard line. There's a flag across the field at the 13. One back at the 30.
Well, they're both. There's going to be holding on both sides. Holding in the offense, but in the secondary, they had an up and go, or rather a stop and go pattern, and Wyman Henderson got caught for the hold on the other side. Wyman Henderson with the goggles there, pleading his... put his hand on the back of the official there.
There was a double foul on the play. Holding on the offense, number 85. Holding on the defense, number 24. The penalty's offset. Replay, first down.
Jonathan Hayes, tight end, Kansas City, and Wyman Henderson, corner of the Broncos.
Watch what the play action pass does to Wyman Henderson. Freddie Jones cuts the assistant. Now watch the cut. He just flat out tackles him. Just flat out grabs him. That's an easy call by the official.
So we bring it back to the 22 and his first down.
Some definite frustration sitting in on the part of the secondary for the Broncos.
But they cannot afford, as you mentioned, to lose their cool. They could be out of the ball game. To the 17-yard line. So he'll pick up five on the play. It'll be second down and five. Michael Brooks with the tackle. Brooks injured last week, did not practice at all this week, but then was able to run yesterday. And so Dan Reeves said, we'll start a trailer, but Brooks will play as much as his injury will allow him to play.
Well, he has a deep thigh bruise, and of course, Michael Brooks leading the team the last 2 years, you can see in tackles, also leads them again this year with 40 plus tackles. He's somebody they have to have in the middle of that defense to stop Barry Wood.
Barry Wood Jones, the lead blocker, and he cannot get around the corner. Bill Jones, the lead blocker for Barry Wood. Mecklenburg was there. The defense of the Broncos just screened them out.
Nobody will ever mistake Carl Mecklenburg for Carlos, but watch number 77. Watch his pursuit. They're to the right of the screen. Watch him run all the way out there with Barry Wirt, take the proper angle, and push him out of bounds. And I know he probably doesn't want to hear me say this, but for a relatively older guy, he still runs pretty good.
In fact, they lose a little bit on the play. It'll be third down and six.
Five-time Pro Bowlers, you see, he's used to playing all over the field. Now he goes from inside linebacker to right defensive end to rush the passer.
Four wide receivers for Kansas City. Touch pattern into the corner, and it is incomplete. As Jones came in for the post, was breaking back to the corner.
One of the things that Joe Pendry, the offensive coordinator for the Chiefs, told us last night, that a flaw that Dave Craig has is that he's not quite used to the reads. He had excellent protection. He had plenty of time to throw that corner out. He just threw it far too soon, and Jones hadn't even made his break yet, and as a result, it's an incompletion, and they're forced to kick another field goal.
Nick Lowry now. A 36-yard attempt.
I was going to say, if Dave Craig would have held onto the ball just a split second longer, he could have had the touchdown.
Buckner with the hold. Connie Kawhi, the snapper. And it is good. And so the only man for Kansas City who has won in Denver in a Kansas City uniform, Nick Lowry.
If you depend on your truck to last, here's news you should never forget. Of all the Chevy trucks built in the last 10 years, over 98% are still going strong. That's more than Ford, more than Toyota, more than Nissan. Over the years, no other truck is that dependable, foreign or domestic. Only Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
It's the Domino's Pizza NFL Spectacular. What are these guys into? Piling it on. And if you're into piling it on, get a Domino's Medium with unlimited toppings now, just $8.99. And pile it on.
Nobody knows like Domino's.
Wow! I feel good.
Yeah, this guy really gets around.
He's got the auto lights.
American Auto Import, we're guaranteed
2 years no matter how far he goes.
That's why we've been everywhere. Wow!
Why did Hertz invent number one club gold service? To beat the rush hour. See, every plane and everybody seems to land at once. But with gold service, there's no stopping at the counters and no paperwork. Instead, you go nonstop to your waiting car with your name and lights. Only Hertz has number one club gold. The best reason yet why Hertz beats the rush hour. To Hertz, the rest of the day is a piece of cake.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Hertz Number One Club Gold. Hertz's fastest service now in more locations coast to coast. By Castrol Syntec, the new synthetic oil that protects in ways others can't. By your Allstate agent who wants to be your agent for life. You're in good hands with Allstate. And by Chevy Trucks, the trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last.
Charlie Jones and Todd Christensen with 11:19 time remaining. We're in the third quarter. Kansas City leading Denver by a score of 13-3. Nick Lowry will kick off with Montgomery and Marshall, the deep backs on the return. And this goes to Marshall's side and will go through the end zone for the touchback, and Denver will bring it out to the 20-yard line.
We mentioned that even though Dave Craig is a 12-year veteran, there are some things that he has to learn, and a lot of it is terminology and nomenclature of the system. Both Joe Pendry and Marty Schottenheimer come over to say, look, take your time. You have the guy in the corner. Don't worry about it. We'll get him next time.
Denver's first offensive opportunity in the second half. They start from their own 20-yard line. And Denver has not scored a touchdown now in their last 11 quarters of play. Away it is high, it sails on him. Shannon Sharp, the intended receiver, and it will be second down and 10 at the 20-yard line.
John knows that's him. Play was set up perfectly, had excellent protection. Sharp over the middle, he just threw it too high.
What does an NFL quarterback do the morning before a showdown game in Mile High Stadium with Kansas City? He goes to a soccer game.
Goes to watch his daughter play soccer?
Daughter Jessie. Still, I can't talk to you long. I've got to be there in 15 minutes.
Yeah, that's too bad, because I didn't get... Well, I have to work. He gets to go. I didn't get a chance to see my son catch five passes, one for a touchdown, and have his team come from behind 12-0. They won in overtime, 18-12. Congratulations to the American Force Redskins.
Incomplete. Shannon Sharp, the attended receiver.
Now, that certainly was close with regards to Tracy Simeon. Earlier, this is a play that would work where Sharp comes in off the inside backer. Watch your tight end number 84. He's going to lean into Simeon, come out. Does he get there before the ball? It's close. Very close. I think it's a good non-call. As with the other one.
Third down and 10.
But in that case, he certainly didn't alter Sharp's ability to catch the ball. So I'm sure that's something that the officials took into account.
Ball throws. Pass is complete. First down, 41-yard line. Arthur Marshall.
Arthur Marshall showing an impressive ability to run routes for somebody so young. Once again, the double cover here on Thomas. Elway able to step up and throw the short corner to Marshall there at the 40-yard line, right in the seam between three Chiefs, enabling the Broncos to keep this drive alive. And at this point in the game, it would have been horrendous for the Broncos to have gone three and punt right here.
Denver from their own 42-yard line, converting on 3rd and 10.
It's interesting. I believe we've yet to see Vance Johnson.
He has been in the game. They have not thrown to him. The number two tight end, Reggie Johnson, 49 yards.
Right down the middle of the field, he finds the seam in the zone, and there's absolutely nobody there. Mincy breaks the tackle at 255 pounds. He shows some pretty good speed. Drags Kevin Ross along the ride for another 10 yards, and now there are the Broncos knocking at the door on the 10. Excellent use out of all three tight ends. We have seen Sharp earlier in the game catch a lot of passes, and now Johnson with a big ball.
And Gaston Green, he's going to leave about a half a yard, and that's going to be it. The crowd's reaction, they want Elway to throw.
Dan Saliamua once again defeating Keith Karch to make the play in the backfield. Watch the middle of your screen. Watch number 97. He breaks through, comes off the center's block.
Defensive play by Kevin Ross.
Marty Schottenheimer said something very interesting about Kevin Ross. As we have a little bit of a skirmish on the other side of the field, flags are down. We'll see what this is about.
I'll tell you something else. Kevin Ross had something interesting to say. He said, "I have to win in Denver before I retire."
Well, the way he played right there is indicative of his desire. 9-year veteran. Diving play to break it up. Trying to see what this melee means, what goes where. I'll save that Kevin Ross story for you here in just a second and find out what it is. Chatting with the official.
There was a double foul on the play. It's a personal foul, number 90 on the defense. There's a personal foul on the offense, number 72. Number 72 offense is ejected from the game. The penalty's offset. The down counts and is third down.
Keith Karch has been ejected. He is the starting center for the Broncos. Also, he is the snapper on field goals and extra points.
And there he is. He's letting him know. Now Karch is arguing the point. Wait a minute.
You eject one and not the other, is what he is saying. Now the referee is coming to the near sideline to explain it to them.
Well, it wasn't, of course, it's not the referee's call. You can see Keith Karch is talking to the umpire. That's who he's having the debate with. Once again, trying to plead his case with the official, but it's not the official that made the call. And as you mentioned, Charlie, I don't know. Certainly, it's going to hurt them to have their. Oh man!
Down and Dave Wydell is the 10-yard line to Reggie Rivers.
Good defense there by the Kansas City Chiefs. Backpedal into the end zone, make them throw it underneath, give them some concession yards, and force the field goal.
Denver trailing by 10, can cut the margin to 7. David Treadwell will attempt. And Dave Wydell will be snapping. Now, he normally snaps on punts, and Cart snaps on field goals and extra points. But Wydell will be snapping here from the 12, an attempt of 22 yards. And it is good from 22 yards away. And the score is now Kansas City 13, Denver 6. We'll be back with a kickoff.
One of these engines was filled with Castrol Syntec, a new synthetic oil. The rest with conventional oils. They were then drained and started without oil to prove a point. You see, Syntec's unique molecular structure bonds to engine parts. Lab tests show it leaves a layer of protection far stronger than conventional oil. And if Syntec protects this well now, imagine if you leave it in. Castrol Syntec protects in ways other oils can't.
More than a million of you have gotten to know Geo, the most successful new line of cars and trucks ever introduced. Get to know Geo at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Getting to know you.
In developing a completely new car, the possibilities are endless. At Geo, we brought all the pieces together beautifully. The newest Geo, Geo Prism, coming soon to your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
When we're together, I want her to be thinking about just one thing. Me.
Sometimes, I'll just see a certain guy and want to get close to him.
Frustration's okay when you're playing tennis, but not when you're close.
If a guy smells, it's such a turnoff.
Get a little closer with Arid Double X, the anti-odor antiperspirant. Arid Double X helps keep you extra, extra dry.
Yeah, I trust Arid.
Brad D'Aloiso will be kicking off for Denver. As you have seen, he can certainly nail the ball. Early in the first half, I tried to mention to get to the fact that he is the flaky kicker. This was actually pointed out by Mike Aran, the Denver punter. Says he kicks right, he throws left, he writes with his right hand, he bats left, he plays golf right-handed. Says he really can't figure out what he wants to do. But boy, does he have a strong leg.
When he dances, does he lead or follow?
Both.
Okay. Well, he can do it. You're right. He can do it. That's right. I still wonder, though, I still question
carrying three kickers,
whether or not you can justify carrying three kickers, because that's all well and good that he sets him at the 20. But, Charlie, here's an interesting note. The average kickoff return in the National Football League, 18 and a half yards. In effect, what he's given them is a 20-yard return.
But also, you have to realize that he is not going to give them an opportunity to return it for a touchdown. He's supposed to be upright again. He is awesome. We'll be back in just a moment.
You looked scarier 25 years ago.
Did I?
You looked scared.
I don't know. I thought I hit it well for an innocent groom.
You were innocent for the 60s.
Any regrets?
None. You?
Just one.
What?
That I waited 25 years to give you this.
The 25th anniversary diamond, a brilliant celebration of a loving marriage.
I've got goosebumps.
Well, you've given me goosebumps for 25 years.
It takes strength to go climbing 7 days a week.
The sun upon my skin, right around. Hard against the wind, like a rock.
That's why one compact pickup powers you with the biggest full-size V6 engine you can get. Only Chevy S10 Tahoe 4x4. Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
This is the runaround. To not get the runaround, call an Allstate agent who promises that after talking with you about your claim, his claims expert will call, usually in an hour. You're in good hands with Allstate.
It's the Domino's Pizza NFL Spectacular. What are these guys into? Piling it on. And if you're into piling it on, get a Domino's Medium with unlimited toppings now, just $8.99. And pile it on.
Nobody knows like Domino's.
Steve Martin.
What a great
Rick Moranis.
Stay out of trouble.
The network television premiere. My Blue Heaven, NBC Tonight.
Art Demis, the umpire, explaining to Dan Reeves what happened here, and Dan Reeves has to tell Keith Kartz that he has to leave because he's been ejected from the game. He has to leave the sidelines. And as best as we could tell from the play, here's what happened. Here's Kartz in the middle. Here's Neil Smith. And at the end of the play, watch near the 10-yard line. They're going to start into a fight. And I believe, as best as I could tell, it appeared that Kartz might have kicked him. Because usually in those fracases, Charlie, they take swings, and of course nobody really gets hit because they're wearing a face mask, but somebody will swing and kick a leg or something, and that will provoke the umpire referee to make that call.
Barry Ward carries from the Kansas City 20, and he matches his numbers. He takes it to the 23. And it will be second down and 7.
Marty Schottenheimer right here wanted to keep the momentum that his defense held on there and forcing him to kick a field goal, and they had first down at the 10-yard line.
And Marty told us yesterday, to be legitimate, we have to beat a quality team on the road. Second and 7. Flags are down.
Dave Zott took off too soon.
False start prior to the snap on the offense, number 79. 5-yard penalty, it remains second down.
On Dave Zott.
Part of the problem here is the forgotten 5 will be the remembered 5, but for the wrong reasons. Trying to get a jump start right here. Leans a little bit too soon, anticipating the count. Cost the Chiefs 5 yards.
And it's second down and 12. 6 minutes, 47 seconds and counting. Kansas City leads by a score of 13-6. The middle, the pass is complete to Keith Katz. Interesting catch, the number 2 quarterback, the number 2 tight end for Kansas City with the reception. And Reggie Johnson is like number 89 for Denver with a 49-yard reception, which for Reggie Johnson was his first of the year.
Watch how Dave Craig just aims this ball, just drills it right in there, right into 89. And Keith Katz, many people felt was a blue chip prospect out of Texas. He went to Pittsburgh, things didn't work out, signed as a plan B free agent, and they looked to him to make some of the catches that Jonathan Hayes cannot.
And that is his 4th reception on the year, and it is a first down at the 32-yard line. Bill Jones is in motion. Ward jumps to the outside. Good defensive play for Wyman Henderson. Need of a couple, it'll be second down and 8.
Usually Barry Ward just lowers his shoulder and runs over the smaller defensive backs, but as you say, give Henderson credit for coming up there and making the hit. Only a 2-yard gain.